we now study loop invariants. Loop invariants will be used to help you understand loops more easily. More importantly, we want to give you a skill in developing loops. We don't just want to simply show you algorithms, we want to teach you how to develop them. In this class, we teach programming rather than just programs. Once you learn about loop invariants, we will be able to develop searching algorithms, sorting algorithms, and other algorithms that manipulate arrays efficiently and effectively. You will then find these algorithms much more memorable, not because you memorize the code, which is almost always impossible, but because you can develop the algorithms from their specifications. Let's look at two algorithms and discuss your current inability to understand or develop them. The first algorithm is for exponentiation. The Java code given below computes b to the c under the assumption that c is greater than or equal to 0. For example, if b is equal to 3 and c is equal to 4, then the algorithm stores 81 in z. You can see that the loop terminates, since initially y is greater than or equal to 0, and each iteration reduces y by at least 1 while keeping y greater than or equal to 0. But how can you conclude that z contains b to the c when the loop terminates? At the moment, we have no way to explain that to you. You can hand execute the algorithm for some initial values of b and c to see that it works, but that does not help you know that it is correct or know how it was developed. This next algorithm is for sorting an array. The code on screen sorts array b. You can execute it on some test cases, but that doesn't help you to remember the algorithm or to be able to produce it at will. Executing an algorithm on a few cases rarely gives such understanding. We will show you a simple methodology that will let you develop the algorithm. Then you can do it whenever you want. You just apply the methodology and the loop writes itself. A general principle in any engineering discipline is to split a complex task into several parts, each part as independent as possible. When all of the parts are done, they are put together to complete the original task. We should do this with loops too. Look at the initialization in the first example given above. Y is x set to b? Y is y set to c? Y is z set to 1? You can't know that until you have understood the entire algorithm, probably by repeatedly executing it by hand. Why does the loop terminate when y is 0? Again, you can't know that until you have looked at all the code and understood it all. You need to understand the entire algorithm to understand each of its parts, which goes against the engineering principle. Loop invariants will help us put this engineering principle into practice for this loop and all other loops, allowing us to understand the initialization without having to look at the loop itself.